Hello, everybody. I'm Jason Chen. I'm going to talk about this clothing store. It's called Uniqlo. I think everyone will know this store. And this is the online. And today I'm going to talk about their business model and development and CSR. And the experience I work in the Uniqlo. And before I talk about business model, I would like to talk the history first. Uniqlo is the first SPA store in Japan. SPA means specialty stores. Specialty stores, retailer of private label apparel. 中文是自由品牌服装的零售商。 And then this is the business model, and the most left side is the R&D department, means research and design. And it's for marketing and researching the some source. And the middle part is the factory. Obviously, it's for the producing the clothes. And that's the oversight. It's a sales department. And it's separated by two departments. It's online store and a real store. So, and the departments, the development of and their producement. And finally, is high, they have high quality and further low price, and they still always have this latest trend. Because they provide high value supplies of top materials at low cost by negotiating with negotiating directly with the material manufacturers. And about the trend, they are efficient because they quickly make adjustments to the latest sales trends and minimize the gross operation costs, such as personal expense and their rent. And this is how they have cost down their cost price. And the development of the Uniqlo is they have now Uniqlo have about 852 stores in Japan, and at the end of 2014 August, and since 2001 they opened the first store, and the international store expanded to about 633 stores around the world, including 334 in China and 133 in South Korea, and about 80 in South Asia. And this page I want to talk about CSR is corporate social responsibility. It's like a charity for giving people who need clothes. And since 2007, Uniqlo has concluded with this organization called UNHCR, and they work with, they provide the clothes for those who we need, like victims and victims and refugees and some single parent families and so on around the world. And how they recycle. You can see around the real store, and they always have some boxes for this pen green and is for recycling. But before recycling, before you giving them the clothes, you need to clean it up before you giving them. And they only accept the only living clothes items, every item. So the clothing, pants, and some shoes, or anything else. And now I'm talking about I work in the living clothes. I think everyone. I thought before I go into this store, I think they work very easy because I think they just need to put the clothes right and just clean the floor and nothing else. So I think it's very easy. So I just go to interview and going to interview, and I saw about 100 to 150 person to fight for the job. So I think I maybe have no chance for this job. But after about 3 days, they sent me a mail that they told me go to work. And so I'm surprised. And Uniqlo is the Japanese store, so they very care about the rules and time. And because this is Japanese store, so the customers always are the prime. This is unbeatable. So if the customer says, you are king, then I'm king. So okay. And this is the photo I work in the Uniqlo and take by my friend. And let me talk a joke. Once a fat boy come to our store and he asked me to measure his yoke, and then I take my rope and throw him, and before I throw him I think that maybe he is about 110 centimeters, but our pants main size is about only 92 centimeters. So after I roll him, then I get the
size.
然后他讲，哦，然后那你不敢，他很胖，就没有，就是哦，没有那么大size，对吧？你这样跟他讲，你这样跟他讲，对吧？好，耶。
We don't spend too much time, so we have 1.5 minutes for Q&A. So, do you have questions for him? I think he introduced Uniqlo because he worked there. And then the second thing is Uniqlo really is really a good company with recycling and provide the growth for those people who really need. I'm not sure it's for the people who are
like Africa and some regions.
Africa, Fezo and some regions. So, well, through his presentation, I could not find any key words from him because he did not show many things, just the images. So, maybe the only thing I can pick up is the UN Refugee Agency, REFUGEE. What is the meaning of that word? Okay, and also the sentence, the only sentence I picked up, which is important for his maybe customers, they are always the prime. I'm not sure why they say are the prime. Usually we say they are queen or they are the king. 顾客永远是对的，他们是国王或者是皇后，至上，至上的，对，他们，they are always on the prime. So I think you can, would you please write down this one? At this refugee.
Okay.
Thank you. It's fine.